In this video, I'm going to be explaining you about why 270 degree crank angled twin cylinders are becoming very common these days. You can see these type of configured engines in the retro and classic motorcycles, as well as the big capacity adventure motorcycles. And let's get started with it. Now, why 270 degree a crank angle is very important? If you see a parallel twin engine, which is observed in the normally Ninja 300 or the Ninja 650, Yamaha R3, M207, all these motorcycles, it is a normal 180 degree parallel twin engine. And in a 180 degree parallel twin engine, everybody complains that it doesn't have a character, which will engage the motorcyclist or the rider to ride the motorcycles. But wherein you consider a V-twin engine, it has a very good rumble in it. You have that classic and retro kind of feel in that 90 degree V-twin. But the disadvantage that is obtained in these type of engines are these cannot be used in a compact motorcycles. Though it can be used for a narrow motorcycle which can zip through the traffic, but it cannot be used for a performance motorcycles which you can move left and right quickly. The nimbleness should be compromised if you use this kind of an engine. So in this type of engine, the V-twin engine is very long. Actually, it takes up more space in terms of length, so it cannot be moved around the chassis so well like a parallel twin engine. Whereas in a parallel twin engine, you can move a bit front and back, and you can perfectly design the motorcycle according to the chassis for the right center of gravity. So if you don't know what is this 90 degree and 180 degree and 270 degree angle of the crankshaft, I'm going to be explaining in this video. So let's get started with that. Now, why you should consider a parallel twin engine with a 270 degree angle is it combines the compactness and lightweight of the parallel twin engine, and it gives the engine that V-twin fun exhaust also, which has been the trademark of V-twin engines. When you consider 180 degree angled parallel twin engine, you can see that the piston is moving up and down in the angle of 180 degree, and the second piston is moving up and down at 540 degrees. You can also observe that both the pistons are at a stationary at the same point or moving at the same point. Whereas when you consider the 360 degree crank angled parallel twin engines, you can see that both the pistons are moving at the same time and in the same angle. Both the pistons are moving up and both the pistons are moving down at the same time and at the same angle, due to which it is almost has the same characteristics of a big single cylinder engine. That's where 270 degree crank angled parallel twin engines are considered to be the best, because it combines the 90 degree V-twin characteristics and a parallel twin engine. Because of which the first piston, which is moving at an angle of 270 degree, and second piston is moving at an angle of 450 degree. This gives the engine a good character of a V-twin, and it has an physical appearance of a parallel twin. Now, the main question is why can't they just use a V-twin and just be done with it? As you know, because of the handling issues, the engineers must be able to manufacture a motorcycle which will be on par with the handling capacity of a modern motorcycle. That's the reason why parallel twin engines are used more than a V-twin engines nowadays with a 270 degree crank angle. So thanks for watching, guys. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and hit that bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Thanks for watching, and see you in my next video.